Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. So I want to talk about a super common question that I get, and that's, will running cause arthritis? Well, this is an excellent question and one that many people ask me about, especially when they come into my clinic with either knee pain or they've just been diagnosed with osteoarthritis. Will running cause arthritis? Will running make arthritis worse? Do I need to stop running if I have arthritis? So I'm going to answer all of these questions, including going over 5 best practices for those who have arthritis and are trying to get back into running as quickly and as safely as possible. Let's dive right in. Now, if this is your first time watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live a healthy and active lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. Now, most people think that the more you run, the more arthritis you are at risk for getting. And that's because when we run, we are loading our joints, and this would theoretically lead to gradual wear and tear. And osteoarthritis is caused by the gradual wear and tear and the eventual loss of cartilage. So logically, this would make sense. But in reality, the opposite might actually be true. Recreational running actually seems to be preventative. What that means is that running may actually protect the knee and prevent arthritis from getting worse. In addition, people who suffer from osteoarthritis may actually feel better the more they walk and the more they run, and this is supported by many observational studies. Regular exercise and exercise therapy, such as walking or jogging, is actually considered first-line treatment for osteoarthritis. And so why would that be? Well, when we walk, when we run, when we move, our joints naturally produce lubrication, and this lubrication helps keep everything moving nice and smoothly. But if we ever stop moving, well, we stop producing lubrication and things are more likely to get stiff and wear down. Now, this is very much an oversimplification, but all you need to remember is motion is lotion. And running has tons of other benefits. It's protective to our overall health. It decreases rates of high blood pressure and strokes and diabetes and heart disease and dementia. It increases bone health and gives a major boost to our mental health. It also helps us sleep better and gives us more energy. But what about all these anecdotal stories of high-level athletes who develop arthritis at a very young age? Can too much of a good thing actually become a bad thing? And for running, the answer to that might be yes. High-intensity running and long-distance competitive running may be a risk factor for increased rates of arthritis. Exercise and arthritis seem to have a J-curve relationship. And what that means is lack of exercise or sedentary behavior are known risk factors for developing arthritis. On the opposite end, extreme exercise and elite level training is also an increased risk for arthritis. So what we are shooting for is the sweet spot. That's the zone where recreational running and jogging falls in. Getting regular exercise in that sweet spot seems to, number one, prevent the development of arthritis. Number two, it prevents the progression of arthritis. And number three, it gives us health benefits, everything that we just went over. Now, the British Journal of Sports Medicine posted an excellent infographic that summarizes much of what we know about running and arthritis. And here are the key points. Running fact number one, recreational running is not harmful for knee joint articular cartilage in runners without symptomatic knee osteoarthritis. Running fact number two, participation in recreational running may provide a protective effect against the development of knee and hip osteoarthritis. Running fact number three, higher rates of knee and hip osteoarthritis have been reported in non-runners and runners exposed to sustained elite level training loads. However, they go on to say that it is unclear whether these associations are causative or confounded by other knee osteoarthritis risk factors, such as previous injury. Now, this is a very important point to highlight. And take, for example, a person who has torn their ACL before. We know this person is going to have much higher rates of arthritis, and high-level athletes just have more chances of getting injured. So this may explain why rates of osteoarthritis are actually seen higher in high-activity and elite training individuals. So what can we conclude? Well, running does not seem to cause arthritis, nor does it seem to accelerate existing knee osteoarthritis. So if you are a runner diagnosed with knee arthritis, you should feel safe continuing to run. But now the question becomes, how do you do it safely? How do you put your body in the best position possible to prevent injury, especially if you do have arthritis? After all, runners are already at particularly high risk of developing injuries like plantar fasciitis and iliotibial band syndrome and patellar tendonitis, shin splints, stress fractures. And this is why I want to go over five best practices that I want you to implement, especially if you've been diagnosed with arthritis and you're trying to get back to a run. Okay, tip number one, start slow and build up distance and speed. Avoid going too hard if you're just starting to run. Pushing yourself too hard too fast will actually increase your risk for injury. Consider having more frequent rest days, especially in the beginning, and going on shorter, lower intensity run. As your conditioning improves, you start building up more speed and more distance. Number two, cross train. Cross training means getting involved in different types of exercise. Running is excellent for our overall health, but it is mostly a uniplanar motion. We're usually going only forwards. So getting involved in other types of exercise that have more side-to-side motions can actually help build strength in other types of muscle groups. And what this does is it prevents injuries. So excellent types of cross-training activities for runners include strength training as well as yoga. Tip number three, stretch after you run. After any workout, it is critically important to cool down and stretch. Otherwise, over time, your muscles are going to get tighter and tighter, and that's going to result in decreased range of motion. This is already especially problematic in those who have arthritis, whose range of motion is already very limited. Number four, consider running on softer surfaces. Soft surfaces include turf, outdoor trails, or a rubber or dirt track at a local school. Running on softer surfaces reduces the force impact on your joints, which again can be problematic for those with arthritis. Number five, make sure you have proper footwear. This means not only getting shoes that fit properly, but changing them out when they do get worn out. And when you do change them out, you may want to visit a reputable running store. The employees there, now granted, are not medical professionals, but many of them are excellent at evaluating people's feet. Do your feet overpronate? Do you have wide feet? Do you have flat feet? All of these will affect the type of shoe that you will eventually want to select. Now for a bonus last tip, if you have pain when you are running, you need to stop. Pain is your body's way of telling you something is wrong. Get checked out by a sports medicine doctor so that they can help you return to activity as quickly and as safely as possible. Thanks for watching. If you found this information useful, please consider liking the video and sharing with others, and I'll see you next time.